Come here, let me show you something. Who is this? That's God. You see that? Did you ever tell her that this was God? How does this little child know or perceive this to be God? Who is this right here?
Bring it out.
What about this guy right here? Who is that? That's God. You see what I'm saying? Does the Bible describe the Most High God as this man?
Bring it out.
We have been deceived in this country, and these churches are not teaching us who we are or what teaching our children who they are and who they need to become in this world. That's right. Why we stay on the bottom. This is why we're in the condition that we're in. This child is how old? 4 years old. Nobody taught her that this was God, but all of a sudden she's growing up with the perception that this is God. Sister, this is not God.
Right.
Now, you might ask you gotta have a question. Why are black men out here reading out of the Bible, right? Is that floating in your mind? Why is it important that we teach our people the Bible? Because there's like 5 churches right up the street, right? But our people are still in the same condition. I'm gonna show you a condition right quick. What's your name?
Mama.
Huh, Mama? What's your name?
Omar,
come here. Let me show you something. Who is this? That's God. You see that? Did you ever tell her that this was God? How does this little child know or perceive this to be God? Who is this right here?
Bring it out.
What about this guy right here? Who is that? That's God. You see what I'm saying? Does the Bible describe the Most High God as this man?
Bring it out.
We have been deceived in this country, and these churches are not teaching us who we are or what teaching our children who they are and who they need to become in this world. That's why we stay on the bottom. This is why we're in the condition that we're in. This child is how old? 4 years old. Nobody taught her that this was God, but all of a sudden she's growing up with the perception that this is God. Sister, this is not God.
Right.
Let me show you what God looks like according to the Bible, and what these filthy churches are not teaching our people according to the Bible. What you got?
Revelation chapter 1 verse 1.
This is why it's important for our people to come when you see men line the streets in purple and gold to teach the Bible. This is why this is important. We grow up thinking going to college is good, and we're doing all these things that this society provides us is good, but this society mentally, psychologically tricks us without us even knowing it. She's 4 years old. Nobody told her that was God.
Right.
Read.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
This is the revealing of Jesus Christ. Now, had I asked you, brothers, who this was, guess what you probably would have said?
God.
Jesus Christ. Because this is what has been taught to us for over 400 years in this country.
Right.
We got to remember, when this happened to us, we got a whole new doctrine.
Right.
Yes, we got a whole new philosophy of how we should live according to their standards.
Right.
They gave us their God.
Right.
We now have their language.
Right.
We now follow their traditions.
Right.
We don't follow our traditions. Like today is the Feast of Dedication. Have you ever heard of the Feast of Dedication? It's in the Bible.
Read it up.
My pastor ain't teach you that. Because their job is not to educate our people to live according to God's words.
Right.
Their job is to make the money and profit off of the people.
Right.
That's what they do. We're going to find out today who God is, what he looks like. Read.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The root word in the word revelation is what? Reveal. This is the revealing of Jesus Christ.
Right.
This is what Christ looks like. Read.
Which God gave unto him.
Come on.
To show it to his servants.
So God gave this to his servants. Read.
Things which must shortly come to pass.
Read on.
And he sent and signified it by his angel unto his servant John.
Come on.
Who bear record.
How do you bear record? You write it down. Today we bear record with our cell phones. We want to record everything.
Right.
But in these days, we bear record by what? Writing it down. So it's written what Christ looks like. Read.
Who bear record of the word of God.
Uh-huh.
And of the testimony of Jesus Christ.
This is the testimony of Christ. Come on.
And of all things that he saw.
That he what?
That he saw.
So now we're about to see what John wrote down. Something that he saw with his own eyes. Read.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Now look, the Bible says that his head and his hairs were white like wool.
Bring it
now,
up.
Does his hair look white? Lie number one. It said the hair on his head and the hairs, meaning the hairs on his face, were white like wool. Now what gives you a better depiction? This one or this one? Who has woolly hair on the earth? Look at this brother's hair right here. That's wool, brother.
Right.
It said, read it again.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
White in color, woolly in texture. Read.
As white as snow.
Meaning it was fully white. Come on.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
His eyes were red because he drunk wine in moderation. Remember, Christ's first miracle was what? He turned water into wine. He drunk wine. So when you drink wine, the whites of your head, of your eyes turn red. It said his head and his hairs were white like wool, and his eyes were a flame of fire. Read.
And his feet.
Now we're talking about Christ's feet. I got a question. Does your hand and feet are similar to the same color? One may get more sunlight than the other one. So one is naturally lighter or darker than the other one because it is sunlight. But your feet are going to be the same color as what? Your hands. Are your hands going to be the same color as your face?
Bring it up.
When you look at your skin right here, right? Look at your skin on your hands. What color is your skin? It's brown, right? So what color is your face? It's a shade of brown, right? Read on. And his feet?
And his feet!
Uh-huh.
Like unto fine brass.
What color is brass? Brass is a brownish color. His feet, the color of fine brass, come on.
As if they burned in a furnace.
So the brass looked like it was burned in a furnace, sister. So if you take brass, sister, if you take brass that is brown, right? And you burn it, what color does it turn? It's going to turn a darker brown, meaning what? It's going to be charcoal, like black.
Right.
So, read it again.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
His feet like fine brass. You think this man got feet like fine brass?
No.
Come on.
As if they burned in a furnace.
Do you think this man's feet look like they were burned in a furnace? No. Come on.
And his voice as the sound of many waters.
So when we read the scriptures, now give me that in Daniel. When we read the scriptures, this is Christ.
Bring it
this
up.
This is Christ.
Right.
He is a dark-skinned man.
That's
so
right.
When did we get this image planted in our heads?
Bring it out.
During and after slavery. This was implanted in our heads to the point now we don't have to teach our children that this is God.
Bring it
they
out.
Automatically grow up thinking that the white man is God.
Bring it out.
We don't have to even teach them this.
Right.
But if Jesus Christ is a so-called black man, what color is his father?
Bring it out.
His father is black. Does the Bible describe what the Most High God looks like? Does the Bible describe what the Most High God looks like? We just read a depiction of Christ, right? So, what color would his father be? Does the Bible describe his father? Let's find out. Because it's in the Bible. But our pastors are not going to tell us what's in this Bible.
Yeah.
And if we don't go to men of understanding to learn this Bible, we will live our whole lives in fluff and lies,
right.
Not even knowing that, guess what? We are the greatest people on the planet Earth.
That's
that
right.
The reason we're in the condition that we're in right now is because God gave us his laws. He didn't give anybody else his laws.
Right.
The laws were given to blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. The same brown people that you see are in slavery, that are in bondage, that are at the bottom today. We are God's chosen people.
That's
and
right.
because we broke God's commandments, we don't know that I'm an Israelite from the tribe of Judah.
Right.
I think I'm black, African American. We don't know that the Jamaicans are from the tribe of Benjamin. We don't know that the people that call themselves Haitians are really God's chosen people from the tribe of Levi.
Right.
Puerto Ricans are Ephraim.
Right.
These are our God-given names. But because we've been here in captivity for so long, they've stripped us of our names and given us new names.
Right.
You want to call Nigga Coon, Nigga John, John John James. These are not our names. We have taken on the names of our oppressors.
Right.
The Bible describes what Jesus father looks like. Let's find out.
Daniel chapter 7 verse 9.
This is the book of Daniel, but way before Revelation. Come on.
I beheld till the thrones were cast down.
Come on.
And the Ancient of Days did sit.
It says the Ancient of Days did sit. Well, who is the Ancient of Days, meaning older than days? Who is older than days itself? the Most High God, creator of days. Right. He's older than days itself. He is the Ancient of Days. Come on.
Whose garment?
Whose what?
Whose garment?
Now, some people say that God is a spirit, but the Bible said what?
Whose garment?
This is a garment.
Bring it up.
In order to put on a garment, what must I have? A body.
Right.
A spirit can't put on a garment.
Right.
You gotta have a physical body to put on a garment.
Right.
So this fluff that they've been teaching us about God is a spirit, guess what? The Bible says that is a lie.
Right.
They said that Christ was white. The Bible says that is a lie. Read it again.
I beheld till the thrones were cast down.
Come on.
And the Ancient of Days did sit.
The Most High God, he not only had on a garment, but he sat. What did he sit on? A throne. In order to sit, what must you have? A body. Can a spirit sit? Spirits, the perception that they've given us about spirits, they just float. They can float straight through that pole. But the Bible said what? He what?
The Ancient of Days did sit.
He sit, meaning he sat down. Come on.
Whose garment?
Whose garment? He had on a garment when he sat down. Come on.
Was white as snow.
Come on. He had on a pure white garment. Bad garment. Better than what we got here in America. Come on.
And the hair of his head.
The what?
The hair of his head.
So now it's describing the hair that is on the Most High God head. The creator of heaven and earth. You mean tell me he got a body? He can put on a garment? And he got hair?
Right.
Why this thing on churches don't teach this?
Bring it up.
Come on.
And the hair of his head. Like the pure wool.
Like the pure wool on your head, brother.
That's right.
Like the pure wool on your head, brothers and sisters. You are God's chosen people.
That's
you are
right.
Made, yes, you are made in the image and the likeness of the true and living one, Most High God.
That's
you
right.
You are God's chosen people. If we don't come to the streets to teach this young brother that he's a God on this earth, who's going to teach him?
Right.
Who is going to teach this young man? What's your name, brother? John. Come here. Let me talk to you. Brother. This world is gonna beat you down when you grow up. This world is gonna tell you that you're nothing, but that is a lie.
Right.
You are a God, brother.
Right.
You are a prince. Give me that in Psalms. Give
me
that in Psalms chapter 82. You are God's chosen people.
Right.
You are the owner of this planet Earth. Everything that you see around you belongs to you.
Right.
But there's something that must take place. We must come back to keeping God's laws.
Right.
When we come back to serving the Most High God, we're going to gain rulership on this earth again. Thus says the Lord God. Let me show you, you're a God. Come on.
Psalm chapter 82, verse 6.
This is the book of Psalms. Why ain't pastor teaching this on Sundays? Read.
I have said, ye are God.
What does the Most High God say?
Ye are God.
Come on.
And all of you are children of the Most High.
All of you are children of the Most High God. But because we broke God's commandments, because we continue to break God's commandments in our ignorance and not knowing them, because our forefathers broke God's commandments, this has happened to us.
Bring it up.
This is what has happened to us in this country. We've been scattered throughout the whole world, just as God promised he would do his chosen people if we didn't keep his commandments.
Right.
Read it again.
Psalm chapter 82, verse 6.
Listen, you know,
I have said, ye are God.
God is telling you, brother, you are a God. Come
right.
on.
And all of you are children of the Most High.
The blood that's running through your vein is the same blood that runs through Jesus Christ's vein.
Right.
You are a direct descendant of the God, Son of God himself. Read.
Verse 7. But ye shall die like men.
But Most High God said, but you're going to die like men. Like what men? Like the regular men that's created. You see how these other nations out here? These are regular men.
Right.
We are not regular men.
Right.
Nobody else on planet Earth could have survived this.
Bring it
out. Nobody else on planet Earth could have survived 400 years of this.
Right.
We are the only people that could do that.
Right.
We are God's chosen people. Read.
That's right. But ye shall die like men.
But you're gonna die like these other nations out here. Why? Because we chose to bring ourselves low and keep the traditions like the officer was bringing out. Christmas, Thanksgiving. These are the traditions of these men. God gave us many high holy days in his Bible that we're supposed to reverence. Right now, we're in the midst of the Feast of Dedication, a 7-day celebration. Well, you think it ain't no fun in this truth? We partied all night last night in the Lord,
right.
In righteousness.
Right.
You can have fun in righteousness. But we think when we come to serve the Lord in his Bible, you know, we can't have fun no more. God gave us celebrations for 7 days.
What?
A marriage feast can last 2 weeks.
What?
You ever party for 2 weeks? We barely party for 4 or 5 hours nowadays. We tired, can't even wait. If we make it home.
No.
If we make it home.
Bring it up.
But God gives us many high holy days to celebrate. Come on.
And fall like one of the princes.
We're going to fall like one of the princes that are ruling right now. Why? Because we have fallen from keeping God's laws.
Right.
Brothers and sisters, it's imperative that you understand that you are God's chosen people and that you must come back to serving God.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.